There's an old wives' tale that of, well, sort of elephant graveyards, and that sort of starts right back from the Lion King days, where Nala and Simba go and play or find themselves around an elephant graveyard. Now, what normally happens, elephant graveyards don't go to, well, elephants don't go to one spot to die, unfortunately, as their teeth start to wear down, because they've got six sets of molars, and it can be quite problematic. Of course, they're all surrounding those bones now, just picking them up, smelling them, very curious about them. And basically what they did was they would go and feed along the river systems, drainage line, dams, where the vegetation is a lot softer and it's easier for them to chew their food. And then eventually they'll end up dying in areas like that just from malnutrition, not getting enough sustenance. And what happens when a great big flood comes through or the rains come for the year? Those bones end up being washed into and around the dams or into a drainage system and then further down and into a river. And it and often happens where you have more than one elephant dying in that area. But even one elephant would be enough to create an entire graveyard filled with bones. And of course, as you can see here, elephants that pass through are quite curious of this. And they investigate with their trunks, just like they're just exactly like what they're doing now. But this is not from an elephant, this is from a buffalo. But they're very curious and want to have a look. Now, Jenny, you're wondering if elephants can get any diseases from the bones like anthrax? Most certainly. And that's why it is so important out here not to pick up any bones, because you don't know. And the spores can last for many, many, many years in the soil. So, you know, you just got to be very, very careful. So they can. But I don't think there's been a case of anthrax in this area for a very long time. I think well over 10 years, if I'm not mistaken. So they'll just play with it and have a look. So they're fairly safe. I think we've actually collected some bones. Look at that little one playing with a rib bone on the left by the tree. Look, it looks like it's got a big tusk now, don't you think? It's probably going, that's what I'm going to look like one day. I'm going to have two sets of these. Don't eat that. Take that out of your mouth right now. That's what my mother would be saying. And she'd be waving her finger at me, telling me to, because I used to do that when I was little, and I suppose sometimes I still do it now. I put all sorts of things we find in the bush, I put them in my mouth to see if they're edible or not. You're going to take that with you. That is so funny. That's really cool to see. So, now not only do the scavengers scatter the bones, like the hyenas, the jackals, and all those critters, you can see that the elephants are also responsible for moving bones around, because they were all in a very neat pile over there. Not even one hyena came to feed off of that carcass. We sort of monitored it until it completely deteriorated, until not even the carrion beetles were hanging around anymore. We did see some marabou storks and woolly neck storks around here, but other than that, and that was really it. But you're going the wrong way now, elephants. Go back towards the dam. Go and have a swim. Isn't that just a precious little thing? It is lovely, don't you think? Who are you? A little boy. You look like a little boy. No, you're a little girl. You're a little girl. Being ushered back now. Now, a very good question from Michael this afternoon. Michael's question is, would the elephants have a negative reaction to bones if they were of that of a predator, so a lion or something like that? No, not necessarily. I think that their reaction would be the same. I'm sure that they would get the scent of that predator, and these elephants do know lions and leopards and hyenas, and they're able to identify them not only by sight but also by sound and by scent too. And so no, I don't think so. I think they'd be quite curious. I'm sure that they would know that they're dead, and they wouldn't go up to a lion and sort of just play with it. So only just because of the bones. And once again, they're just very curious creatures. They always pick up and investigate. They put things in their mouths, especially the little elephants, as we just saw. Now look at that little starling that's just in front of, or just behind the bones, that Birchall starling. You see, as the elephants moved out, it sort of flew straight in. Now, I don't think it wanted to get stepped on by any of the elephants, but I think there are a couple of insects that were being disturbed in the grass over there. But what a great sighting. Now, I'm going to try and hang around here. They've gone into the very thick vegetation now. Hopefully, they're going to move back around and then come down to Buffalsook Dam and have a swim and stir those hippos.